What is up guys, it's me MrFactualGaming here and welcome back to another video. And also welcome to my first factual video. In today's video, it'll be the start of a new mini series which we'll be talking about. Like basically I'll be comparing two Russian aircraft. I'll also be comparing two Western aircraft. So yeah, before we get into the main part of this video, please like, share and subscribe to the channel. And let's get, just to remind you guys, if we get 10 likes on any of my videos and also we get to 30 subscribers, I will be doing a live stream in which I will be flying to all the seven wonders of the world in the game Microsoft Flight Simulator. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So yeah, the first aircraft we have on our list today is the MiG-25. Now the MiG-25 is also known as the Foxbat because NATO gave it the code name. These names like Foxbat and all that, they're just NATO's code names for them. And by the way guys, just a bit of a disclaimer, these videos are just for educational purposes only. So that's all I really wanted to say. So the MiG-25 was built by the company Mikhail Gurevich. It was the final aircraft built by Mikhail Gurevich, the founder of the company Mikhail Gurevich. It is the fastest interceptor of all time, and it set the world record at a speed of about Mach 3.2 or something like that. By the way guys, just another thing to mention, in the description of this video, I will be putting in like more information that I haven't already mentioned in this video, because really I did include all this information to because I didn't want to make this video to be too long. So yeah, as a lot of Soviet and Russian aircraft were, the cockpit is turquoise. I don't know what reason they made it turquoise, but they just did it turquoise. And it was originally designed to go about Mach 3.1 or Mach 3.2, but it went, the speed due to safety concerns was lowered to about Mach 2.83. The pilot is only allowed to go at Mach 2.83 for about five minutes, due to otherwise there was a serious risk. There would be a serious risk of the engine overheating, and no one wants an engine overheating after all. So the type of engine in this is a turbojet engine. And now, as I said, it is the fastest aircraft to enter service, and also the fastest interceptor to enter service. Another fact that I want to tell you guys about is the fact that it is one of the few aircraft to be made entirely of stainless steel. Yeah, not a lot of planes are made of entirely one material. Most are just made of a mixture of different materials, otherwise known as alloys. Like you got aluminium alloys, you got loads of allies. So, yeah, the plane wasn't just flown by the Soviet Union. It was also flown by the allies of the Soviet Union, like the air forces, which were in the Warsaw Pact. And and a total of 1,186 planes were made. So yeah, that is quite a lot. The most aircraft that have been made, the most of one type of aircraft that have been made is 48,000. So it's not a lot compared to like other planes and all that. So that is all the information about the aircraft that I have. Oh, by the way, the cost of the aircraft, it wasn't really known. Anyway, let's get into our second aircraft. Our second aircraft is the Tupolev Tu-160. The Tupolev Tu-160 is also known as the Blackjack by NATO, because as you know, NATO had its own code names for these planes. And like the MiG-25 and a lot of other Soviet aircraft, the cockpit was turquoise, which again, I have absolute no clue why that is, but it just is. So, the top speed of this aircraft was about 2,200 kilometers an hour. And in max speed, it is about Mach 1.78. The Tupolev Tu-160 is a heavy bomber. It is like, I think, the fastest heavy bomber ever made or something. I am not too sure exactly. But anyway, the engine type was a Kuznetsov NK-32, which I have no idea what that is, but that's just the engine. It has four of those engines, two on each side of the aircraft. One on the port side and the other on the starboard side. And the first flight was took place on the 18th of December 1981. Just to tell you guys, there is also another aircraft which first flew in December. Although this was December 1968, the 31st of December 1968 even. That was the Tupolev Tu-144, which was meant to be the Soviet equivalent of the Anglo-French Concorde. Anyway, that's getting a bit off topic there, so let's get on with the rest of it. It was properly introduced to the Soviet Air Force on April 1987. Its range was 12,300 kilometers. Its weight was 100,000 kilograms, which is actually quite a lot. It's the weight of some like military transport aircraft, like the C-5 Galaxy, the C-17 Globemaster. All them sort of Western transport aircraft and the Ilyushin IL-76. Anyway, that is again going off topic, so let's get on with the rest of it. The length of this aircraft was 54 meters long. And the aircraft has also had a variable swept wing, which allows it to fly much quicker and all that. It gives it numerous advantages and stuff like that. It was also flown by, as well as the Soviet Air Force, it was also flown by the Ukrainian Air Force, Which, of course, Ukraine was one of the Soviet Union's allies, and I think was also part of the Warsaw Pact. Only 35 of these things were built, believe it or not, which is quite rare, although some aircraft are much rarer still. The cost of this aircraft was 160 billion rubles, or in US dollars, it's the equivalent of about $2.8 billion. So, that is all that we have in today's video. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And remember, if we get 10 likes on this video, I will be doing the live stream in which I will visit all the 7 wonders of the world in the game Microsoft Flight Simulator. So, this is MrFactualGaming signing off.